So right now, the scope looks great, and the technology has really worked well for humans. Right now, the AR/VR integration things which is going on in browsers, and much rich experiences which we now take for granted weren't possible without Web 2.0.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Neeraj, and this is my first podcast. Today I have with me my brother, Deepak Jagir. So he's worked in Microsoft for more than 7. हम इस पॉडकास्ट में बात करेंगे क्रिप्टोकरेंसी, एनएफटी और फ्यूचर ऑफ डिजिटल एसेट्स. सो डीजे, व्हाट डू आपको ब्लॉकचेन के बारे में क्या पता है? व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज अ ब्लॉकचेन?
सो ब्लॉकचेन इज जस्ट काइंड ऑफ अ लेजर, लाइक यू पुट जस्ट ट्रांजैक्शंस इन इट. There is no hold of where you started from. It just holds a bunch of transactions, like where you can transfer it, who do you transfer it, and so what happened?
Basically, yeah. According to you, like blockchain, why start hua tha? Like, what was the purpose of it?
So the main purpose of it was, this was a research project in around early 2000s.
Okay.
So a guy was coming up with. Like to a place to store transactions or some data, but which is proved by multiple people, not just one person.
Okay.
So in current software industry, if I ask you to create Excel sheet, you will open the Excel sheet, create data in it, but no other people are working on it, right? So you will send this Excel sheet across to verify it, but the source was you.
Yeah.
You started that Excel sheet, and now others can verify it. Or update the data. But you guys did synced up together and said, okay, this data should go in this Excel sheet. So the source of truth was, things it started was from you.
Okay.
So now if you made a mistake and others didn't verify it, post that correctly. So it is, the data is now present in that Excel sheet.
Okay.
Right. So that was something that is what we call sometimes like send of authority, like there's a central authority which is doing this, and such a central authority like you putting data in Excel sheet in something like banks and others, other currencies. So this guy was wanted to come up with a distributed way of doing things. So multiple people first verify it, and then the data is committed.
Okay, right. So why like blockchain is called decentralized? Uska reason kya hai?
So blockchain, because whenever you want to put something in the example I gave, whenever you want to put something in that Excel sheet, you first send it across.
Okay.
Then others give you some unique quantity values or signature. They sign it, and then only you can write something in that Excel sheet.
Okay.
You can commit in that Excel sheet. So that proved that now, because of one, there are multiple people involved, that data is will be less corrupted.
Okay.
And now that can be trusted more, because now not everybody only you are editing, but you first have to verify your data, and then you can't even commit it just like switching it off from the internet and then you can just commit things on it. That's not going to be proof. So what other people first have to verify it, then you can put data in it. So this ideally creates a situation where the data is more trusted now.
Okay.
So whatever the transactions and everything is going on, but now because it's more trusted now in a distributed way, I can put money in it. I can create cryptocurrencies on it. I can do things because now
like
I trust
NFT.
The process. Yeah. Yes, like NFT. Because now I trust the process. So in banks, may not people trust, but in distributed computing they still trust, because they are not a single person can't own it at the end of the day.
What do you think ki ab jaisa future aa raha hai to ab like jaise abhi hype chal raha tha last year se NFTs and all they are coming, so what do you think is the future of blockchain and NFTs, unka according to what will be the future like 5 to 10 years?
So generally whatever technical trends you see, people keep trying new things and one of them succeeds. With good marketing, with enough number of people following that trend, then that becomes the truth of life. Like if I would have told you that, what do you think about the first iPhone? in that year you would have asked me, I said maybe it will work, maybe it will not, because BlackBerry and multiple people have already tried it. But the way they presented it, but the way they created an ecosystem around it that supported enough people to take their iPhones to home, and then that created a sustainable system for them to keep improving it.
So I was also talking to him before this interview about NFT and cryptocurrency. So आपने वो example दिया था कि it is like you know human behavior से relation है सब कुछ. So हमारे human behavior जिस तरीके से होता है, it has a big role in it.
Yes. So think of it like this, that when you were born, you didn't have trust in rupees.
Right.
Like why would you care about rupees? But then you see enough people using it around you and they trust that currency.
Right.
So you start believing that, okay, now this currency is useful to me.
Something.
And now because 100 billion people believe that rupee is valuable, so INR works.
Right.
If tomorrow morning I say paper with lines will work from currency, and you find enough people to trust in that concept, then you create a new currency. As simple as that.
Okay.
So similar is with the thing with this NFT or any new trend if you take. So with NFT also, they have created a decent ecosystem now.
Mm-hmm.
Many big names are behind this. Many people see this as making opportunity, making big bucks on this, and they are putting in effort and everything. NFT till now has not proven to be a valuable piece for anybody. Probably some artists, but then most of the people who end up selling things on it will be big corporations. Like they'll be selling like products on it with add-on services, like extra gear on in games,
okay,
which have some unique ID, and they will call it NFT.
They are GIF pictures. They are like celebrities. They are selling pictures.
Yes, yes.
In millions.
Yes. So they see that, okay,
now is it like digital assets?
Exactly. Just the only problem is with the physical land, you have something tangible.
Right.
Like I own this part of. With that gift, it gives you exclusive rights on paper,
right,
but you can't stop it from being. You can't stop it from being shared around.
Right.
So you don't have, because the land, yes, you can create a wall, you can create a house on it, start living on it, and use it.
And you're gonna feel it like I have, yes. I own something.
Yes, you're legally protected and physically protected from usage of that land. Nobody else is gonna come and take that land, because there are rules and everything for NFT. No, that's not the case. So anybody can use gifts. It's tough to track who is sending what gift, or there enormous amount of technologies which can trick you into believing that, okay, you own it, but that still is going to be in people's pocket. So it's just, as I said, it's your trust. If enough people trust that NFT works, it will work.
Yeah, that's it. So Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg changes the name to Meta. So like, have you heard about it? Like,
yes.
So wo plan kar rahe ki, like everything will be more digital. So our whole life will go more digital. So what do you think about that? Like how it will affect our lives or like that?
So from this point on forward, there are two ways I think we can now really innovate humanity. Is either we go interplanetary, like we go to different planets, explore different things, or we go into this virtual world direction, that all of the humanity is working to make this virtual world successful, and probably it will. So if I had 100 rupees and you asked me to put between these two, I would put on interplanetary. Like, because Meta is something which makes money, which is fun to watch, but at the end of the day, it's not that useful to humanity.
Okay. In the future, it won't be that, according to you.
Like, yeah, till now, it hasn't shown, even Facebook hasn't shown its value to people. It mostly for people to just waste time. Probably some people have innovated on top of it and learned new things, and probably,
right,
but most of the time, you just see people swiping their mobile screens. So it has not proved that much worth for the humanity, but at the end of the day, it has kept people connected. So it has pros and cons.
Next question I want to ask is about Web3. This is going on and trending. So like Web1 was the internet age, when internet was introduced in our humanity. So like in 1990, in 1990s, they were like web 1. People call it web 1, and then they were like static websites only at that time. Then web 2 was like e-commerce and everything. People were buying and selling, and there was more stuff in internet, right, in games and all. Now they are telling that web 3 age is coming in 2030s. So what do you think, like, web 3 will be like? What will the advancement in IT or technology? How will it be?
So whenever you say like we jump from web 1 to web 2, mm-hmm. so there was not a particular date when we shifted that from today onwards. So when the web 2 term catched up, people already using web 2 from few years, like 4 or 5 years,
right.
And so has been with the case with web 3 as well. So what generally when people say web 3, they when they said web 1 to web 2, they say that it was a big shift in technology wise. Like we started doing really tough things on top of web. So similar shift has happened with Web 2 to Web 3, that we have introduced AR, VR in web browsers now. A bunch of technologies has changed that it has created. So I would argue that it is in 2.5 or 3.
Right.
But yes, we have already been in shift from Web 2 to Web 3 since many years. So right now the scope looks great, and the technology has really worked well for humans.
Okay.
Right now the AR, VR integration things which is going on in browsers, and much rich experiences which we now take for granted weren't possible without Web 2.0.